Oh God, please.
What do we do with him?
No. Nobody touch him. Looks like we got another fuel leak.
What the hell happened? This thing is 50 years old. Yeah, it looks like the valve failed.
All right, let's get it shut. We can't afford to lose any more after that attack.
Okay, I got this. Hold that part steady.
What's that?
Just need some more leverage. Damn it. No, stripped. Wanna give me a hand?
Yeah, sure.
Let's take these guys out. Don't know if there's any more guys around here.
My eyes.
Huh. I'll check it out.
Roger that.
Show yourself!
What? There's no time to strangle him. Get him bloody shot at.
This ends here and now.
Shit. Holy crap. Right. Wait, do we need to? No, no, no. Okay. Salute these guys. Don't need that. I wonder if we could make Molotovs in the future. Should we kill this guy? Yeah. I think that's the humane way. Excuse me. I think there was a guy up here. Just gotta loot this guy. Oh, I can't pick up that box of ammo, which is unfortunate. Right. Now, the thing is, how to get out of here. So we can't get out there. Oh, right, of course. Thing is, how do we light this on fire? Could use this lantern. Oh shit. How the hell did he know where I was? Oh shit. Okay, I think we need to get out of here.
Constantine is here. The man who tried to kill me in Syria. He's violent, dangerous. But worse, he appears entirely devoted to his misguided beliefs. I seem to have a habit of running afoul of religious zealots. But I suppose it all goes with the territory. His men on the radio mentioned a prisoner with information. Could it be one of the natives I've encountered? And if so, what does he know? Trinity will not be kind in their methods. Perhaps I can find him. Find out what he knows. Earning the trust of the locals might prove useful.
Right, so we're just putting skill points on. See what there is in Brawler. That's pretty good. Automatic loot enemies while stealth killing them. Got a weapon upgrade. for this revolver. And the climbing axe. Right, let's get going. I've actually forgotten how to, like, the controls and stuff like that, because I've been playing The Division a lot. There's some kind of a map there. Scroll. Can we climb up this? Look at her hair, Jesus Christ, that is awesome. Right, I guess we're going down there. I'd like to know, no, let's just go for it. Oh shit.
Don't shoot, I'm not your enemy.
Who are you people?
All that can come later. If you want answers, then listen close. We've managed to destroy the old radio tower, but there are repeaters that keep them connected. We need to shut them down. Help me, and I'll let the others know they can trust you. We need all the allies we can get.
Yeah, I think we should help them.
I'll keep an eye out for them.
Good. We don't have much time.
Optional mission indicator. Survival instincts can highlight locations and objectives. Okay. Right, that requires a lockpick. Okay.
I've infiltrated the ranks of the enemy and learned that they come seeking the rich resources of the mountain. They appear to know nothing of the secret we protect. Those who build the Iron Road are themselves prisoners, slaves of the Red Army. Massive machines now use the Iron Road, bringing more slaves, food, and raw materials for construction of a small city. It is time for me to return to my people so we might plan our attack. If we can inflict heavy losses upon them before they reach the mountain, they may give up and turn back.
So those optional side missions give you rewards, and we can't get into that chest there because we need a picklock. And if we do this optional mission, this side mission, he'll reward us with the lockpick skill. So it seems like these are necessary if you want to, like, get different tools and stuff like that. Wonder what's up here. But I hope you guys enjoyed the Division beta as well. I wonder what that was then. I thought that was a raccoon or something.
We could stop them, but the Red Army outnumbers us. Their weapons are superior, and they just keep coming. Many of my people, including myself, have been captured, forced to work the mines of our own mountain. It's only a matter of time before they discover our secret. When this happens, we must be ready.
Right. I can now translate level 2 Russian. So those little collectibles that we find are actually useful. Actually improves our skills to a certain extent. Right. I like the fact that you can run now in this game. You couldn't run in the previous game.
Communication repeaters. Trinity must have been speaking.
Right, so these are the communication towers that guy was talking about. We could shoot that down. I don't know if we can actually shoot it down with the bow. Let's try it. Can we shoot it with a bow? Doesn't look like it. I actually don't think we can actually shoot it down. Compound bow pattern. That's what we need. There's a lot of exploration in this game as well. Can we get on here? Whoa, what was that? It's giving me the option to do something. Ah, right. Jump off the edge. No, thank you.
You've been the first to light a star of progress. Huh. In praise of cosmonauts.
There's a cave down there. God, there's so much to do in this game. I don't know how long... this series is going to go on for. But it's not like I should miss too much of the game. Because I do want to show you as much of this game as possible. No, go down there, what are you doing?
Need to get more information out of the prisoner. If Constantine has to do it himself, he's not going to be happy.
We'll step up the pressure, but... he's clearly had some experience with interrogation techniques before.
We think he's the leader of the Remnant. He has to know about the Divine Source. Find his weakness. Get creative.
This prisoner. Maybe I can find him.
There's a pack of wolves over there as well. Maybe this is their den? Oh shit. Not good, not good. Oh, hello! Oh, I don't like killing wolves. Oh well, survival of the fittest, right? Is that a body? Well, we've got some more arrows from him anyway. I would like to know what is in this cave right now. Oh, sorry. Come on, please be something decent in here. Oh, we got some kind of ore. Right. Secrets revealed. New mural, new documents and murals, locations discovered. I'd just like to thank you guys. I know I keep saying it, and it's probably getting repetitive for you guys, but, you know, a massive, massive thank you for all the support.
These markings, they're not Russian. A warning, maybe?
What? I'm thinking, if we shoot that log, it would smash through there and we'll be able to get down there. You think? Could we use a bow? No, go down there. Go on. There we go. Right. Got some more ore here. Optional challenge tomb nearby. Okay. We'll go down there just yet. I know I said that I'd try and... No, I said that I would show you just the story and stuff like that. But it's just one of those games where you just can't help yourself and you just want to go and explore.
The prophet was persecuted and so were his followers.
So that's Greek. But I guess that's the whole purpose of a walkthrough, I suppose. Show you as much of the game as possible.
There's water down below. Sounds like a great volume. A coin with an image of a city stamped in gold. And there's the prophet. This was likely an official coin of Katesh.
Nice. Got level 2 Greek now. Yeah, I can now translate level 2 Greek. Right, I'm guessing... Over there. There we go. Got some goodies down here. Let's not go down there. Let's go down here. Oh, another one.
The prophet's icon, cast in gold. The metal workers of the city started to develop their own style, but it's still similar to Byzantine craftwork.
It's very it's very interesting, cool that video games, as long as they're telling the truth,
that's got to be part of the works.
Actually give you knowledge about history and stuff like that. It's really, really cool.
Thank you.
I have no idea what that contraption was, but it got us somewhere.
An oil cask.
Could we shoot that? Yep. Right, we can actually make some equipment. A satchel. Oh, that's cool, that. It actually adds pieces of, you know, like the satchel is on her back there. That's awesome. I wonder if that will stay there through the whole game as well. Yeah, I'd like to upgrade my bow. Nice. Yeah, she's got a satchel on her back now. That is really cool.
Water's eroding everything. At this rate, there won't be much left in a few decades.
How are we gonna do this, guys? I'm sorry I keep using her like survival ability. Oh no! Shit. Tried jumping but she didn't wanna. Oh, please tell me we're not stuck down here. Oh, thank God. Right, let's try that again and actually try jumping this time. Oh, well, what was the point in that? So maybe we need to increase the flow of the water. What's this?
That door, it's holding water back.
Can we throw it? Nice. Can we actually go through that door? We can. Right, so I was right about increasing the water level.
Markings on the wall. The levels change.
Right, so we got some more here. Now I wonder if these can actually float. Ah, no. I see. If we throw this on there and then jump down there ourselves, we need to somehow move. Need to move this raft over there. Can I move it over there? Ah, no. There's some kind of gate there that's holding the water back. So we need to figure out how to...
This platform.
Yeah.
Looks like okay. It's connected to that floodgate.
Yeah, so if we jump on that, should cause the water to come out the floodgate. Pushing the raft over there. That's it. And then when it recedes, we can shoot that, and it should blow up the gate. There we go.
Okay, should be able to swim through now.
So the puzzles are getting a little bit harder. What next? Something up there. I almost missed that. Of a scroll.
This should be more than enough oil to light the passages below, but be careful transporting it. We have not perfected the refining process, and it is still volatile. You will know the man who supervises the construction. We all do. Without his knowledge of the Earth, none of us would have survived along the difficult journey. Do not linger. And if he asks for word of his wife and child, feign ignorance. He cannot accept that they perished during our exodus, and expects them to arrive any day. We need his genius, and I fear if he saw the truth, we might lose him entirely.
Something else up there as well. Is it a relic? No, just some resources. That's fine. So we need to increase the water level again. Right. Somehow. Let me just throw that up there. I believe there's something up here. Nope. Nothing up here at all. What about up here? Just another scroll.
My love, this letter is long overdue, but I have been hard at work. When you arrive, there will be a home for you here with all the comforts we have left behind. It is a huge task ahead of us. To design and supervise the construction necessary to provide fresh water to our people. But all my labor will be paid in full when I see you and our children's faces again. We will create a new world here, the equal of everything you left behind to follow me. It will not have been in vain, as long as you and I are together.
Oh, isn't that romantic? Right. So we still need to figure out how to It's tricky, guys. Very tricky. Has this got something to do with something? Nope. Right, there's got to be something else we have to blow up. Yeah, I see.
How can I get to this one?
Right. I got an idea. Because we can't carry those water, those oil buckets through the water. If we pick one up, put one on there, might actually take two just in case the water pushes it off. So if we put two of these on here, okay, and then we come up here, we open the floodgate, which will obviously push the raft over there. Then once the raft is all the way over to the other side, try and swim to the raft as quickly as possible. Then pick up the oil. And throw it in here. Let's take two just in case.
Yes, it worked.
And then we should be able to throw it here, and boom. Oh shit. Nice. I do like a bit of a challenge. Now we should be able to get this relic or this treasure. Natural instincts. Nearby resources will automatically appear on the map and glow when nearby. Nice. So we don't have to keep using Lara's, was it, survival instincts? Yeah, that's it. Nice one, guys. Two tombs already solved. Can we upgrade our weapons anymore? Yes, we can. Upgrade this revolver. Alright, let's get out of here. I heard that everybody that waited for the PC version are really enjoying and extremely impressed over the graphics of this game. And I can tell you right now that yes, I am impressed as well. Probably rivals that of The Witcher. The Witcher 3 Wild Hunt, because that is a graphically intense game. But I suppose they can cramp more detail into this game because this isn't a true open world game, if you think about it. You know, you've got set paths to follow, whereas The Witcher 3 Wild Hunt is a true open world game.
Trinity's after the source. should find out what they know.
Still, The Witcher 3 is bloody amazing. Right. You see how this, like, bush just glowed when I went past it? Like that? That is cool. There's another tomb? What? Really? Oh shit. Better not be some kind of a bear down here. Just a quick question, guys. What game would you like me to play next as well? Oh, we can't actually get into that tomb because we need rope arrows. But yeah, what game would you like me to play next? There's a game coming out called Unravel, and it's like a 2D game about a little string doll, like a yarn doll called Yarny, and it's a physics based puzzle game. It looks really, really nice, and that comes out on the 9th.
I hope you received my last tape in good time.
So I was thinking on the 9th of doing an Unravel. I'll leave a link in the description to go to their website so you can check out the game and see what you think of it. Oh shit. Jesus. So there's a door there, but we can't go through there. Get some more resources. So Lara is actually crouching right now, which signifies to me that somebody is nearby. Could be wrong, but I don't think she'd do that for no reason. Look at this game, guys. Freaking amazing. I'd like to find those towers if I could. Can we translate this?
This writing seems to be pointing to something nearby.
Alright, so it's pointed out. Wow, it's pointed out all these, okay. Coin cash, relic. So these should we call them obelisks? I guess I like obelisks. Oh. They actually point historical collectibles in the game. That them all? Yep. Short and sweet. That's how we like it.
More Soviet propaganda.
Maybe the prisoner's in here. Supply shack. Fantasian coins to purchase items from the Trinity equipment technician. Okay.
Look, I'm on your side here. I've been working as a maintenance tech for Trinity out here, but I've got to get out of here. These people are insane. I've been stockpiling gear. It's yours. If you can pay for it, they won't notice a few missing items, but if they catch wind, or if they see me with you, I'm a dead man. I'll need some untraceable currency in case things go south. Gold, preferably. You think we can make a deal?
I'll see what I can dig up.
Right, so we don't actually have any...
It's not nukes. Creepy-looking guy with a scarred face named Constantine gave us a big speech, talked about destiny and something called the Source. And frankly, I'm even more baffled. The other contractors seem to be just as antsy and nervous as I am. But the company men, the guys who've been with Trinity for a long time, they're drinking it up and asking for seconds. It's fucking Jonestown out here. We're preparing for an assault. Against who, you might ask? I mean, there's people here, like natives. Lost in time. We're talking furs, skins, and iron arrowheads. We're about to go meet them with attack choppers and 50 cal machine guns. I'm on the wrong goddamn side of history.
So we do have gold, but we just don't have enough to buy anything from that guy. But that's quite cool as well. So those coins are actually currency. Like I said in the previous previous video.
Your reports have ceased. Trinity's growing concerned.
We've had trouble with the natives. Our communications were offline, but everything is now under control.
If the situation becomes untenable, we will step in.
It won't. You sent me for a reason. I was chosen for this. I will succeed.
See that you do.
Hey!